Yes.
Good evening, everyone. Before we begin this Mass, we would like to sing the Angelus, and then there'll be announcements afterwards, and then we'll sing the entrance hymn. The music can be found in the yellow or gold, or at least the words. So look, you can join in, follow right along, one after the other. So sing the Angelus first. You can remain seated until we have the entrance hymn.
Thank you.
of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good evening and welcome. I want to welcome some people today. They're not going to be here, some of them. First of all, Charlie E., who was a vocalist at the first Polka Mass here. He was supposed to be here. He had a little fall last night, and he's recovering, but he's unable to be here. But Charlie would have been here if he didn't have that accident last night. Also, Don Luke eventually became a percussionist with Polka Mass, and Deacon Greg Hutar was a director with them, and they can't be here either, so we wish all of three of those well. There is one area of continuity, and there was a little 14-year-old boy who was here serving at the first Polka Mass, and he is here again today. Where is he? Oh, there he is. So those of you who do honors maths, you can figure out what his age is. Anyhow, as we come together now, we recall that we are sinners and we seek God's mercy as we confess. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Ever-living God, constantly accomplish the Paschal mystery within us, that those you are pleased to make new in holy baptism may under your protective care bear much fruit and come to the joys of life eternal, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
First reading is taken from the Acts of the Apostles. As the number of disciples continued to grow, the Hellenists complained against the Hebrews because their widows were being neglected in the daily distribution. So the 12 called together the community of the disciples and said, "It is not right for us to neglect the word of God to serve at table. Brothers, select from among you 7 reputable men, filled with the Spirit and wisdom, whom we shall appoint to this task, whereas we shall devote ourselves to prayer and to the ministry of the word." The proposal was accepted to the whole community. So they chose Stephen, a man filled with faith and the Holy Spirit, also Philip, Prochorus,
Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas of Antioch, who was a convert to Judaism. They presented this men to the apostles, who prayed and laid hands on them. The word of God continued to spread, and the number of the disciples in Jerusalem increased greatly. Even a large group of priests were becoming obedient to the faith. The word of the Lord. Our response psalm is, Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you.
Hallelujah. said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, if we do not know where you are going, how can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, and the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you knew me, you would also know my Father. From now on, you do know him, and you have seen him." Philip said to him, "Master, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us." Jesus said to him, "Have I been with you for so long a time, and you still do not know me, Philip? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, 'Show us the Father'? Do you not believe that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me? The words that I speak to you, I do not speak of my own. But the Father who dwells in me is doing his works. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me. Or else, believe because of the works themselves. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes in me will do the works that I do, and will do greater ones than these, because I am going to the Father." The Gospel of the Lord.
Remember where they were when they heard that JFK was assassinated or that the 9/11 bombers had struck. Today I am remembering how I first heard of Father Perk's polka mix. I heard about it on a Saturday morning in Reamer around 10 o'clock in the mid-70s. I was on my way to the post office pick up my mail, as I regularly did, for the post office closed at 10:30 every Saturday. As I approached the municipal powerhouse, I saw there were a number of nicely dressed people standing outside around the entrance. And as I got closer, I saw that one of those outside was Father Perk. I says to Perk, "What are you doing in Reamer on a Saturday afternoon? Or Saturday morning? What are you doing in Reamer on a Saturday morning? I think I feared a takeover or something like that," Perk. And he said they were on their way to Park Rapids, Minnesota, to do a polka mass. And a couple of them were using the facilities in the powerhouse, or so the story went. So as I waited, I asked Father Perk, I said, "What's a polka mass?" We missed that one in the seminary. It didn't exist, I think, then. He explained it in some detail, and I signed on for one immediately, but it was so popular that I had to wait in line for over a year for it to happen. So here's more or less the explanation that he gave me. As a result of the Second Vatican Council, folk masses were being celebrated, often using folk melodies or similar styles. Father Perk did not celebrate the first polka mass. That happened in Ohio by a priest named Father George Velasco, who did one polka mass in 1972. He told Father Perk about it, and the revolution began.
So the first Polka Mass was celebrated in this church, and Father Perk went on to develop the Polka Mass to a whole new level and spread the lively hymns around the world. While the rest of the Mass remained the same as usual, these polka hymns unlocked the joy of the Lord in people's hearts in a way that never happened before. The melodies for those early five or six hymns at a polka Mass, the melodies came from the folk traditions of Croatia, Slovenia, and Poland. The words were adapted by a variety of local talented composers, including Mary Svek. I suppose imitation is the most sincere form of flattery, and in time, these polka masses were served up by music from other Slavic countries, by polkas from Germany, and even the folk tunes of Italy got translated, even though they were not polkas. They kind of followed the same trend. O Sole Mio was adopted into the Mass by Rocky Lucarelli and I Cantatori. So there was a flurry of imitators also around Minnesota that began celebrating the Polka Mass, such as Renata Ramanik in Cloquet with her band Girls, 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 the Slinging Slovenes in Duluth, and the Dobosinskis, named some of the ones I heard in my lifetime. Polka Masses went viral all over the country. But we believe that the worldwide development and popularization of the Polka Mass began right here on May 5th, 1973. Father Perk's choir was popularly known as the Perkatones. And they were backed by a Croatian guitar player, an Italian saxophonist, a Finnish drummer, a French bass player, and a Slovenian accordion player. In short, Joe Svek and his orchestra. And they led most of the polka masses, the music in them. I'm sure many of you have read Father Perk's book, Dancing the Polka to Heaven. It's available there for $5 in the back of church, a giveaway practically. It was published almost 20 years ago. And I got a full page in it for my five lines that went something like this. The spirited music of the Polka Mass reached out to his own people and to many nationalities precisely because it was folk music, the music of the people. It added greatly to the spirit and gaiety of the Mass. It quickly captured a national and world audience, hola, olio. Well, last Sunday, we heard about the Good Shepherd. The sheep will follow the familiar voice of the Good Shepherd. They will not follow the voice of a stranger. And people knew these tunes, they were familiar to them. They knew these tunes in the old country. They sang them on the boat coming over, the short of the journey. And now, lo and behold, those melodies had made their way into church. With new words, but still the melodies made their way into church. So it was a great thing for them to hear the familiar tunes, to hear the familiar voice of God in these melodies, making it familiar, like the voice of the Good Shepherd. It's very well known that Father Perk took rather reluctantly to the changes of the church following the Second Vatican Council. One of these changes brought us from a Mass with mostly Latin words and music to a Mass in the words and music of the people, the vernacular, as it was called. Father Perk was a late starter, but he took to that change with an enthusiasm that could never be described as reluctant. He bravely dished up a whole new taste in church music that didn't exist before. Sure, he had to endure a mini inquisition in our diocese. It's mostly about being gone too much from the parish here. And some others, probably priests, probably brought it up and said he was gone too much, and So they had a big meeting down there in Duluth about it all. And I guess Perk defended himself rather well. And he asked him, how many letters do you receive from Eveleth about Polka that I'm missing in action because of the Polka Mass? And he said, none. So anyhow, the Irish bishop that was here at the time, Paul Anderson, praised Father Perk, praised the Polka Mass, and after that there was no stopping him. His music also passed muster with the Polish Pope, John Paul II. Perk describes watching the Pope's red shoes tapping along the polka music. The polka music was apolitical. The polka mass was apolitical. It received rave reviews at the inauguration of Governor Rudy Perkovich, where the outgoing governor, Wendell Anderson, who was probably Lutheran, I don't know that for sure, but I'm guessing, the outgoing governor said he never saw so many people smiling in church. It also received a letter of blessing from President Ronald Reagan. Your spiritual gift is truly appreciated, and Nancy and I are grateful for it. So the Polka Mass was seen by all sides as good. In an ecumenical twist, it arrived in the Lutheran Church. For example, parishioners filled their Brooklyn Park Lutheran Church in the cities three times in one Sunday for the Polka Mass. It featured in movies, especially one like Wild Rose. The biggest congregation at a Perkovich Polka Mass was estimated over 10,000 at the Pershing Auditorium in Lincoln, Nebraska, presided over by Bishop Glennon Flavin, and with Perk as the main celebrant. It was embraced far and wide, by congregations in Slovenia and Croatia, from Hawaii to Alaska, to Michigan, to Caribbean cruise, and all kinds of places in between. So Father Perk's Polka Mass passed every hurdle of legitimacy, of popularity, and longevity. And so we've had 50 years of uplifting history to celebrate. Truly, he danced the polka to heaven. And this deserves our gratitude tonight, and that is why we're all here. Say thank you to Father Perk and to what he did for our liturgies. I'm going to give the last word to Father Perkovich. He said, a good doctor looks for new medicines, new cures. I operate the same way, and I think the Polka Mass cures sleeping in church. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth.
care and concern for each one of us, we turn now to the needs of our hearts, and these are prayers of petition.
For the church, that we may faithfully follow Christ, who is the way and the truth and the life, obeying his command to love one another and showing the world the way of the God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders and citizens of powerful countries, that their commitment to peace and justice inspire others, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those in our parish who were recently confirmed, that the Holy Spirit give them courage to be witness to their faith in our world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
Lord, the saints we have come in.
sisters, pray that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, by whom the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice has made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that we may come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praises, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he blessed it and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Pope Francis, our Bishop Daniel, the clergy, and all your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let's offer each other a sign of God's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. And may the body and blood of Jesus bring us to everlasting life. Most of you probably come forward to receive Holy Communion, but those who cannot, there will be someone going around
and about, but to indicate you want to receive Holy Communion, hold up your hand or stand up or something to indicate to the minister that you wish to receive in your place, okay?
Prayer to you, we sinners on earth profess. 5 years since Father Kirk died. And when he died, Linda Tyson, I think he used to call her Meet the Press. So Linda wrote this, "There will be no funeral, a bittersweet irony, for Father Kirk loved such a beautiful farewell as the funeral mass." So this mass we are, I'm sure, all praying for his intentions, and it serves as our beautiful farewell to a priest who specialized in beautiful farewells. So let's sing the hymn that's in here in his honor. And "Above the Mountain," let's pray that Father Perk is above the mountain, okay? Fantasy of Father Perk trying to teach the angels the Polka Mass. Must be kind of funny up there. Anyhow, when Father Perk died, almost 5 years ago, Father Fred Method was his executor, or one of the executors, and Fred and I used to golf together every Wednesday, and after a while, Fred said to me, "Have all this perk stuff from the Polka Mass, and I don't know what to do with it." And one of the items was this stole. The stole is the priestly symbol of ordination, for how you get ordained a priest with the stole on you. So anyhow, we don't know exactly who made this stole for Father Perk, but it's been part of the Polka Mass from the very beginning. You can see them. Fred brought over all the stuff one day, and he says, "I know exactly who to give this to, who will be the conservator of this, all this perk stuff forever and ever." So I gave it to Johnny Snyderich, and he has taken care of it ever since. And about the furthest thing from my mind when I gave it to him was that one day I would have the privilege of wearing this stole for Father Perk's 50th. So that's a great honor to be here to do that. I want to thank Johnny for organizing this evening and getting it all together. And all the supporting cast, their names are too many to mention, but they're all on the program that you have here. So thank you everybody who helped put all of this together today. So let us stand now and pray. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Now again, all these videos and books and things are for sale at $5 each. The proceeds go to the Range Historical Society. So it's a good cause to support that, even if you don't buy a book, but give to that cause. I'm a member myself for years, and it's good to join. Anyhow, I think there's 10 places left downstairs for dinner, and Sam has those tickets somewhere, and she'll move her whole operation downstairs, selling the tapes and everything after Mass. So anyhow, let us go in peace now to love God and to love the polka.
We'll sing two recessional hymns. Let the sun shine in, and then we'll follow that with that evening.